Hi everyone, it's that time again. Very excited to announce the Exceptional Piano Student of the Month. I'm also very excited to be in the new space. So sorry we didn't have an Exceptional Piano Student of the Month named last month. I was just crazy busy trying to work on the new space and get us moved in, and I'm so excited to be here. I hope you all love it as much as I do. So back to business. The Exceptional Piano Student of the Month for July goes to a student who has just been remarkable to work with. Henry came to me a little over a year ago, and he had been taking lessons for about 3 years, so he started when he was in fourth grade. When he first played for me, I was absolutely blown away at the difficulty level that he was playing at, especially for being as young as he is, and for only playing for about 3 years. I was just blown away. So he's gonna play for us. He's gonna talk to us. His mom's here. Congratulations, Henry. You deserve this award. And let's get to know Henry.
For July Exceptional Piano Student of the Month, the award goes to Henry. I'm not gonna say your last name because this will be on the internet.
Okay.
So Henry, tell us a little bit about you. Where do you go to school?
I go to Maury Middle School.
Okay.
I'm going to go in eighth grade after the summer.
Awesome.
And what made you start piano lessons?
I don't remember.
You don't remember? Okay. So you were how old when you started?
Fourth grade. I thought it was earlier.
It wasn't though.
Fourth grade. Okay. And you've been taking lessons from me for about a year, I think?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, great. So what are some things you like to do other than playing piano?
I like to fence.
Like climb fences?
No, like sort of like swords and stuff.
No way.
Yeah.
Wow. So tell us about that. Is it a group or how?
No, it's a one-on-one sport. You're using to talk with the braces.
So how long ago did you have braces?
2 days ago.
2 days ago. So we'll give you a break if you can't talk very good shit right now,
okay.
Right?
Okay. The sport we're going against someone and using like kind of swords.
How long have you been doing that?
For a while.
Yeah, maybe since like second grade or
something.
Wow, so you're good.
Ish.
You do competitions?
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah? And have you ever gotten hurt?
Yes, but not too bad.
Not too bad.
So most time I got hurt just because I didn't move wrong, like just rolled my ankle or something.
Oh, okay. So nobody stabbed you?
No.
All right, good. Who's here next to you?
Mom.
And what's mom's name?
Mom. Look
at
Liz.
Hi, Liz. Thank you for being here. Can you tell us a little about Henry, like what kind of baby he was?
Yeah, he was a very active baby. He needed to be moving at all times. We had to carry him around all the time. His dad had a little move he did to make him stop crying. Like this. He'd go, shh. So we did that for like hours on end.
Oh my gosh. And what about as he got older?
And then as he got older and started talking, he became very chatty. This isn't so much now, but he used to just talk your ear off and sit next to someone and they would just chat. And teachers would say, he's like a little adult. He just sits there and has whole conversations
with
you.
So. Yeah. I notice he has a maturity about his. Yeah,
right.
For sure.
So he used to talk everyone's ear off and he's always liked to do things that are active and musical. So.
Uh-huh. So I have something here for you for being Student of the Month.
Yay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Little known fact about Henry, too, is that he also plays other instruments.
He does.
Yes.
What else do you play, Henry?
Clarinet.
Clarinet? Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
And learning how to play the concertina.
The what?
Concertina. It's like an accordion thing.
I didn't know that.
And you play it on your knee.
I bet the fact that you play piano helps out with those instruments as well.
This concertina teacher was very impressed.
So you said that he is the one that asked to play lessons for
piano?
Right,
so he asked us to play piano when he was little, and neither his dad nor I have any musical background at all, so we had to find the music teacher, and then we had to pretty quickly find a piano to get into our house.
Usually they get the piano. We didn't have anything, so we did.
We actually borrowed a piano for a little while from the teacher, and then we ended up just by finding
it. It just seems random, though, because like if he had one at home and he was tinkering around on it, it would be one thing.
No, I don't know what urged him to want to do it, but he picked it up pretty quick, and he had a great music teacher at Corey Elementary back in the day, and they taught him how to read music, and that really helped.
Awesome. Yeah. Would you mind to play something for us?
Sure.